Okay, so this is the first video for chapter 3, sequences and series. So this is arithmetic sequence and series. Okay, so firstly, let us look at the formula in arithmetic. So we have a few formula. The first one, this is the n, so that means this is for the n term. So the formula is a plus n minus 1d, so a is the first term. Meanwhile, the d is actually the common difference. And then we have as n, so this is the sum of the first n term. So the formula is n over 2a plus n minus 1d, or you can actually use n over 2a plus l. L is actually the last term, or your dn, so that is the last term. And then Tn is Sn minus Sn minus 1, our common difference from Tn minus Tn minus 1. Okay, so let us go to the first example. Okay, so example 1, the fifth term. So fifth term, that means this is T5. So the fifth term and the 15th term, so this is T15 of an arithmetic series. So this is As, or 52 and 622 respectively. Find the first term, so we need to know what is a, the common difference, so I have to find out what is t, and the sum of the first 20 terms, so I want to find s20 as well. Okay, so let us write down what do we know so far. So I know t5, the fifth term, so this is a plus v4t, which is actually equal to 52. So that is the first information that we know. Then t of 15, so this is a plus v14d, so this is actually equal to 622. So that is the second information. So now to obtain the first term and the common difference, so let us solve this simultaneously. So firstly, let me do second minus with 1, so a minus a, those two will cancel out. 14d minus with 4d, so that one will become 10d equal to 622 minus with 52. So this one will give us 570. So that means d is actually equal to 57. Okay, so in order to calculate the a, let us substitute into the first equation. So a plus with 4 times with 57. So this is actually equal to 52. So a is equal to 52 minus 4 times with 57, so minus with 228. So a is equal to negative 176. Okay, so I already have the first term, I have the common difference. So now let us calculate the sum of the first 20 term. Okay, so s20, so this is equal to 20 over 2. 2 times a, so 2 times negative 176 plus n minus 1d, so 19 times with d, 57. Okay, so this is equal to, so 20 over 2 is 10, so we got 10 times with 731. So this one will become 7310. So that is S20. So we are done with the first question. So now let us proceed with the second question. Okay, so for the second question, the first term of an arithmetic series is 6. So this is the value of A, and its n term, so this is the n, equal to 51. The sum of the first n term, so sum of the first n term, so this is Sn, of the arithmetic series is 285. Calculate the values of n, and then we have to calculate the 8th term. So we have to calculate the n and t8. Okay, so a is equal to 6, and so a is equal to 6, tn is equal to 51. So when we substitute the formula for tn, tn is a plus n minus 1 times t equal to 51. So 6 plus with n minus 1, d is equal to 51. So n minus 1 multiply with d is equal to 51 minus with 6. So this is actually equal to 45. Okay, so this is the first equation. So now let us use the second one. So we got Sn. So Sn is equal to 285. So the formula for Sn is n over 2. 2a plus n minus 1 times d. So this is equal to 285. So let us substitute what is the value of a. So we got n over 2. So 2 times with a, so 12 plus n minus 1 times d. So n minus 1 times d is actually 45. And this is equal to 285. So this is the second equation. Okay, so now n over 2 is simply equal to 285 over 12 plus with 45. So this is actually equal to 5. That means n is actually equal to 10. Okay, so now I do know that n is equal to 10. So let us check what is the value of d. Okay, so we got n minus 1d equal to 45. So n is 10, so 9d is equal to 45. That means d must be equal to 5. Okay, so now I know the value for the n and d. So now let us calculate the 8th term. So d8, so this is actually a plus with 7d. So a is equal to 6 plus with 7 times with 5. So we got 6 plus with 35, which is simply equal to 41. Okay, so we're done with example 2. So now let us proceed with the last example. Example 3. The 7th term, so 7th term, that means this is D7. And the sum of the first 11th term, so this is S of 11. Of an arithmetic series are 77 and 704. Find the first term and the common difference. So we got to know what is the value of A. Common difference, that means we need to know what is the value of D. Hence, find the least possible values of N such that the sum of the first N term, so sum of the first N term as N, is greater than 1000. Okay, so now let us calculate the first term and the common difference first. So t of 7, so this is a plus with 6d, and this is actually equal to 77. So that means a must be equal to 77 minus with 6d. So this is the first equation. Okay, so s of 11, so this is 11 over 2. 2 times a plus n minus 1, so plus 10d. So this is 704. So now let us bring 11 over 2 to the right hand side. And then let us substitute a equal to 77 minus with 6d. So we got 2 times 77 minus 6d plus with 10d equal to 704 divided by 11 over 2. So this is 128. Okay, so 2 times with 77, so this is 154. Minus 2 times with 6, so this is 12d. Plus with 10d, equal to 128. So that means negative 12, positive 10. So this is negative 2d, equal to 128 minus with 154. So this is negative 26. So that means d must be equal to 13. Okay, so once we know what is the value of d, let us substitute into the first equation. So a is equal to 77 minus with 6 times with 13. So when you simplify them, you should be able to see that the value of a is actually equal to negative 1. So we got the first term and we have the common difference. So done with these two. Hence, find the least value of n. Okay, so now we need to answer the last one. Okay, so Sn should be greater than 1000. So let us substitute the formula. N over 2, 2a plus n minus 1, d. So this one should be greater than 1000. So let me bring the 2 to the right hand side and let us substitute the value of a and d as well. So n. Okay, so 2 times with negative 1. So this is negative 2 plus n minus 1. D is 13. This is greater than, so 1000 times with 2. So this is greater than 2000. Okay, so simplify this. So this is actually n times with, so negative 2, negative 13, so it will become negative 15. So we got 13n minus 15 greater than 2000. So bring everything to the left hand side, expand this. So this is 13n square minus 15n minus 2000 greater than 0. Okay, so now let us factorize this. What you will have is either n plus 11.84 or n minus 12.99 greater than 0. Okay, so draw a smile graph. So this is negative 11.84 and this is 12.99. So greater than, so above, so either n less than negative 11.84, oops, 4, or n should be greater than 12.99. Okay, so obviously n shouldn't be any negative number, so this one should be rejected. So that means we are going to accept n greater than 12.99, which means that n should be equal to 13. Okay, so do remember, since we have inequality over here, you should solve them like what we did with inequality. So that means for this case, this is a quadratic inequality. Therefore, you should either use the table of sign or graphical method, or you can use real number line for this. Okay, so with that, done with the arithmetic sequence. So I'll see you guys with geometry. So I'll see you in the next video.